That's everything you need right there. Just a power source, like a 9-volt battery or a small solar panel, a piece of cardboard, a couple of pencils, a glass, and a couple of wires. Hope you can see that okay. It's just pouring off that one side. This is how the pencils are put together, through the cardboard, space them about an inch apart, sharpen all four ends. And what you do is you drop it into the glass of water. Again, that's just tap water. And you just take the leads, clip the black on and the red on, hook it to the battery or the solar panel. As soon as you do that, you'll see bubbles appearing at the tips of each pencil. I'll show you that in a second. Let me give you a shot of the solar panel here. Okay, so there it is. Comes in the door. Connected up to the top of the pencils. They're dropped down into some tap water. The reason there's so much more hydrogen than oxygen is because when you think about it, water is H2O. Now the trick is to capture that hydrogen to use it for fuel. That's harder. Just using a solar panel, some water, and a couple of pencils, you can convert sunlight into electricity, and then use that electricity to break water into hydrogen and oxygen gas. It's amazing. Beautiful. Love it. Super simple little experiment. And by the way, this is totally safe. That's not enough hydrogen to cause any problems. This is a typical experiment they do in school all the time. And that's just a small 12-volt solar panel, directly connected to the tips of the pencils. You can also use a 9-volt battery too if you want, instead of the solar panel. Alright, and here's a quick shot of it hooked up to a 2-amp regulated DC power supply. So I'll be able to put 3, 4.5, 6, 7.5, 9, and 12 volt settings through this. And I'll check and see if the higher the voltage, the more the bubbles. Alright, here it is on 12 volts. Now let me decrease the voltage down to 9. Slows down a little. 7.5. A little more. 6 volts. 4.5. And finally 3.